First things first, I just want to start off this video by saying sorry for being away for a little over a month. I had issues to take care of outside of YouTube, but everything's good now, and I'm back to making videos. I honestly missed you guys, and like I always say, thank you for your support. And if you are new to my channel and not subscribed, subscribe, because I drop basketball videos and I cover different topics of the NBA. And don't forget to hit the notification button to get notified whenever I drop a video, if you are subscribed. Once again, it's 3rd IV195 coming at you with another video. Stay tuned. Now that the NBA awards are done and over with, until next year, I feel like it's the right time to make this video. I had the idea to do this video for months, but after seeing the opinions of others about certain players getting snubbed from winning an award, it helps to make this video even more unique than what it already was going to become. There's millions of people in the world that believe this.
LeBron James is the best player in basketball and was the MVP this year. Okay.
And I have to say I agree. I'm a James Harden fan from when he was a sixth man back when he was on OKC. I'm not taking anything away from Harden because he did deserve the MVP award, but LeBron did as well. So I see where you are coming from if you are a person that believes that LeBron got snubbed from winning the MVP award for this past season or for seasons prior to this past season, because LeBron really did deserve the MVP as well. And I know you're probably thinking, if I said James Harden deserved the MVP, but he's agreeing that LeBron deserved it as well, what is he talking about? Huh? Now here's the thing. This is where baseball comes in. And if you are wondering why I'm talking about baseball, this is my channel art, if you haven't seen it already. Baseball and basketball are one of my favorite sports. So from time to time, I'll merge baseball into a basketball video or basketball into a baseball video if it matches the topic. And I have a lot of those type of videos coming out in the future. And I actually did that with some of my videos already in the past. And those are the videos popping up in the suggestions throughout this video so far, and will be popping up throughout the rest of this video. And if you are a basketball fan and a baseball fan as well, or just strictly a baseball fan, I have a lot of baseball videos that I'll be dropping in the future. So stay tuned for that. Here are two things the NBA needs to change about the process of how NBA players receive awards. Number one, change the voting process. Make it just like in the MLB. The NBA needs to have two different players win the same award from two different conferences. Just like how two different players in two different leagues win the same award in baseball. For the basketball fans, if you are wondering what the difference between a conference and a league is, it's this. A league is something that can be private, professional, and unpaid. And in the MLB's case, it's professional, because everything involved with the MLB is professional. And for the baseball fans, a conference is a collection of teams divided in different geographic areas. That's why in basketball, you have East and West. In baseball, you have the American League and the National League. And the difference between those two leagues is this. The National League consists of 15 teams that are older than American League teams. The National League was founded back on February the 2nd, 1876. The American League consists of 15 teams that came 25 years after the National League teams. The American League was founded back in 1901. In baseball, each and every year, fans get to vote for players from two different leagues. And this is something that I feel like the NBA needs to do. You can have fans vote for two different players from two different conferences. And in the end, the two leading vote getters from two different conferences end up with the same award. So things will be more fair and it won't leave fans or any players salty. For example, if the NBA did things this way, Donovan Mitchell wouldn't go home empty-handed. He would also win the Rookie of the Year award for the Western Conference. He was my pick for the Rookie of the Year, but unfortunately, Ben Simmons won the award, which he deserved. I'm not going to lie. So if it went the opposite way and Donovan Mitchell won the award instead of Ben Simmons, that would be injustice to Ben Simmons as well. Here are some individual awards from baseball. You have the MVP award, which we all know what that stands for, and Jose Altuve from the Houston Astros, that's in the American League, and Giancarlo Stanton, who played for the Miami Marlins last season before ending up on the New York Yankees for this season, who played in the National League before coming to the American League, are the most recent winners for the MVP award. There's also the Cy Young Award. This award goes to the best pitchers in the MLB for the season, and Max Scherzer from the Washington Nationals, who's in the National League, and Corey Kluber from the Cleveland Indians, who's in the American League, are the most recent winners. And also the Rookie of the Year award. Aaron Judge from the New York Yankees, who's in the American League, and Cody Bellinger, who's on the LA Dodgers from the National League, are the most recent winners. There's also the Manager of the Year award. A manager in baseball is what a coach is to a team in basketball. And the most recent winners for that award are Paul Molitor, who's the manager for the Minnesota Twins, who's in the American League, and Torey Lovullo, who's the manager for the Arizona Diamondbacks, who's in the National League, are the most recent winners. And choosing coaches from different conferences to win an award would be great for the NBA as well, because I believe that coaches get snubbed as well. And I think that Mike D'Antoni should have not went home empty-handed this year, even though he won the NBA Coach of the Year last year. There's many more baseball awards, but I'm sure you get my point by now. Number 2, new NBA awards. I feel like the NBA should add these awards. This is something that I have been saying for years, that I want the NBA to add. And I mentioned this to some people, and they laughed with no comment. I know this is gonna sound weird, but one of the awards I feel like the NBA should add is the Sophomore of the Year award. Adding this award would be good for the NBA, in my opinion, because it's something new. Plus, imagine how Ben Simmons and Donovan Mitchell would be competing to win this award. This was one of the closest and toughest years to choose who should be the Rookie of the Year in NBA history. And here's the thing, Donovan Mitchell and Ben Simmons were going at it with each other. Ben Simmons even threw shade at Donovan Mitchell. He said, "I'm 100% Rookie of the Year. I'm not impressed by any other candidates." Now that's clearly throwing shade at Donovan Mitchell. Then Donovan Mitchell responded by saying, "Ben Simmons shouldn't be considered a rookie because he's been drafted and was in the NBA for a year before him," which I disagree with. Even though Donovan Mitchell is one of my favorite young rising stars in the NBA, because Ben Simmons never played a day on an NBA court until this season because of his injury the first year he got drafted. So it was right that he was considered a rookie. Donovan also wore a sweater with the definition of a rookie on it as well, to further explain how he feels about Ben Simmons being considered as being a rookie. On the sweater it said, "An athlete playing his or her first season as a member of a professional sports team." Adding this award wouldn't be great for just Simmons and Mitchell, but it would benefit other players about to be sophomores next season and in the future, because guys that have missed out on winning the Rookie of the Year award would work hard in order to take their game to a higher level in their second season to be considered to be the leading candidate for the Sophomore of the Year award. Another award that the NBA should add is the Rebounder of the Year award. I know that doesn't sound appealing either, but hear me out here. Rebounders deserve more credit, and I know rebounding is a part of offense and defense. That's why you have defensive rebounds and offensive rebounds, but I feel like rebounding should be singled out and actually become an award. In my opinion, the NBA should have looked into this after Dennis Rodman led the league in rebounds per game from 1991 to 1998. He was the first person in NBA history to lead the league that much times in rebounds. Players like DeAndre Jordan, Hassan Whiteside, and Andre Drummond, and more, deserve more credit for what they do on the rebounding end, because it's not easy. It actually takes a lot of skill to rebound on a high level, not just willingness. And like they all say, offense wins games or defense wins games. Depending on the saying you go by, rebounds are a part of both. Remember that. Overall, in my opinion, the NBA adding more awards would make the NBA more competitive and enjoyable to watch, because rewards brings out the best in people. It makes people want to compete more, especially athletes.
I was averaging 18 points the year before, and then I was finished 6th in voting for MVP, and I got Defensive Player of the Year. So my goal was to come back that year and get MVP.
No matter the sport that's being played, NBA players even take 2K ratings serious. Imagine if more awards were being added in basketball. But that's it for the video, guys. And like I always say, please like and subscribe and hit that notification button and comment below. Tell me what you think, if you agree, or what other awards you feel like should be added that I haven't mentioned, that don't exist. Your opinion matters. And follow me on my Twitter and Instagram account. It's the same name as my YouTube channel name. And share this video. Peace.
Sell it for free. Put no prices on that body. Sell it for free.